My name is Manju Kalanidhi, and this is for the TNIE videos, the New Indian Express. And I have with me the super vibrant, energetic, young, and beautiful actor, Sanya Malhotra. Welcome, Sanya.
Thank you so much, Manju, for such a lovely introduction. Thank you.
You are every word of that. So, from Mrs. Meenakshi in 2021, to Mrs. Manekshaw in 2022. Tell us, like, how's this whole journey has been for you?
It's been quite amazing, to be honest. I think 2021 was a very fulfilling year for me professionally. Baglet and Meenakshi Sundareshwar got released, and both the films got a lot of love from the audience and from the fraternity as well. So I think as an actor, I can say that really has given me that push and that confidence. And also I think professionally, I'm really looking forward to working with some amazing directors. I've been very lucky, to be honest, Manju. I think these 5 years of my career, I have worked with amazing directors and co-actors. And I have learned a lot being on set with them. So, I'm just going to carry that forward in 2022 also, and really looking forward to working with Meghna on Sam Manekshaw, Sam Bahadur, with Vicky Kaushal and Fatima. So, dekhte kaise jaate hai, because 2021 has really given me a good sense of like confidence.
Right. So, to those of you who love Sanya and her work, we all know how she made a big splash with Dangal and then held on to her role despite the big ensemble star cast that, of course, we witnessed. And then, yeah, you played a role in Badai Ho, which was also a big grosser. So I guess you do have some lucky work. And then Paglet, and then Meenakshi Sundareshwar, where you played this new bride, Tamil bride. Is it true? I mean, I read about how much of hard work and how much of homework you put into these roles. Is it true that you can actually, walk with a matka on your head? It was for a role, I think, in one of your roles that...
For Pada.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. So, and of course, you must also have learned wrestling. So tell us about the kind of homework that goes into making of these roles.
For me, Manju, I've never learned the craft. So when I did Dangal and we did all the prep for it, we learned the sport and we learned the language for the character. And I could see it on screen that really worked. And since I could convince myself that I'm that character, the audience also somewhere was convinced that this actor can be that character. So I saw that, and that kind of like, I think that's my conditioning as an actor, because I started off with a film like Dangal. I know that I have to put in that much amount of homework for all my characters. So that's some sort of a conditioning that I have as an actor. Ki koi bhi film ho, or koi bhi character ho, I just cannot and I will not take it lightly. I always try and put in some sort of an homework and prep for all the characters that I have played till now. Whether it was Dangal, Photograph, Patakha, Badhai Ho, Paglet and Meenakshi. I think on screen those characters look very simple. But somewhere as an actor, you have to convince yourself that you are that character. And I really like it when I start living like that character, where I somewhere like those boundaries between me and the characters get blurred, you know. I really like it. I really enjoy it as an actor. That's like, that gives me some sort of like fulfillment. Ki chalo theek hai, like I'm not that character anymore. So that way, I think that really pushes me and I really like it whenever I'm doing a film.
And you do, there are times where you do take professional classes, right? I mean, that's almost like learning a new craft. And are you very welcoming or is it tough? Is it challenging? How does it work for an actor like you?
No, in fact, the first time ever I took an acting workshop is for Paglet. And sorry, for Pataka. And since the character was so different and I could not relate to it, so I had like that acting workshop really helped me to get closer to the character. And I could see ki this is really helpful. This like learning something new about acting is something that I keep pushing myself. And that's also somewhere like my biggest fear as an actor, that I don't want to repeat myself. And I do not want to repeat my characters or something that I've already done before. So I know this fear, I'll have to come like face it sometime in my career. But that is something that's like a driving force for me as an actor, to keep experimenting with the different forms of prep and maybe taking other people's help. I keep interviewing my actors' friends also, that what do you do to prepare yourself? So I keep like getting inspired by other actors and what they are doing to prepare for a certain character. So that is something, it's a driving force for me. Yeah, I keep experimenting and I keep looking for like motivation from other actors and other artists that I really like watching on screen.
So Sanya, I know that you are into fitness. I mean, your social media posts talk about how you challenge yourself every day with your personal trainer. I know that you are a dancer, you're a choreographer. I mean, you actually choreographed this song for Aamir Khan, and which I'm telling you, that is like a real masala song that I've seen. It was a secret superstar. And Of course you are an actor, but what is your first love? There always has to be a first love. Which among these three is really pulls you and why?
Acting is my first love. Being on set and playing a character and forgetting myself, playing those characters is definitely my first love. I love being on set. I absolutely love being in front of the camera. That happiness that I experience while doing that, nothing like makes me that happy. Like all the other things do make me happy. Like I really like dancing too. But then definitely acting is my first love.
Okay. Is choreography also something that you would consider in future? Because you had a really big number with that. Something you're looking at?
I think I was not looking at that at all. But I'm extremely grateful that I got that opportunity, you know. Because I still can't believe that I was able to pull that off. I honestly thought that Advait, the director of Secret Superstar, was joking with me when he came up with this idea that I should choreograph that song. And I really, for the longest period of time, I thought that both Aamir sir and Advait were joking about it. But I'm extremely grateful that I got that opportunity. I got to learn a lot. And why not, like in future, if I have to choreograph some of my songs, then I will definitely be up for it. But it's very difficult to actually choreograph your own self when you are also doing the same thing in front of the camera. I've not done it yet, but I think maybe in future, if I get that opportunity, I will take it up.
Okay. So acting it is, and of course, other things would definitely add to your persona of an actor. Now, tell me about the exciting work. I know that you have nearly two or three movies that you're working on. So what does 2022 hold for you and for people who love your work?
There are so many exciting projects that I'm working on. There are so many exciting things that we have not still announced. And quite excited for this year. I'm excited because a film that I did last year is going to release this year, which is Love Hostel with Vikrant Messi and Bobby Deol. Okay. And I saw some bits of it yesterday. I dubbed for it and it looks really nice and heart-hitting. It's directed by Shankar sir, Shankar Raman, and I'm really looking forward to watch it, and I'm really looking forward to other people to watch it because it's a film which is very, very close to my heart. There's a film with Vicky Kaushal and Meghna Mam is directing it. That's Sam Bahadur. Right. There's Fatima in it. It's my third film with Fatima after Dangal and Ludo. So that is something that I just cannot wait to be on set with Meghna Mam, and to be directed by her is definitely a dream come true. Then what else I'm doing?
you also spoke about the actors table. I guess it's coming up on Netflix. Is that
the round? It's already out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the round with Rajiv Masand is already
yes.
out.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. The first roundtable Netflix did for the shows and the films and the actors. So I was quite grateful to be a part of it. There were never really amazing actors on it.
Yeah.
So that is already there on Netflix now. Okay. Can you watch it?
You managed to share the space with, I think, Konkana and Tapsee.
That's
super. Right. And tell me, how was it working with Fatima for the third time? Do you guys hang out together after work? What is the kind of equations that you girls share?
To start the shoot for Sam Bahadur, we are not shooting right now, but we still have to like start the shoot. It will start like in mid, maybe this year.
Okay. And what are the lessons you learned in 2021 or 2020? I mean, both the years have been not such great years for the film industry in general, the creative industry, although there was OTT and all. But are there some lessons or are there some beautiful experiences you can recount during the lockdown days?
I think, as you said, it was challenging for all of us. The film industry and even outside the film industry, these 2 years have been really challenging and hard-hitting. But if I can recall, the special moments for me will definitely be that as an actor, I was still getting to entertain the audience through OTT. Shakuntala Devi, Ludo, Baglet, and Meenakshi Sundareshwar came on OTT. And it has given me the right kind of push to my career. And also, creatively, I'm quite satisfied that I really got to entertain the audience somehow in these 2 years.
And how much of social media presence, I don't know, do you think social media really adds to an actor, or there are some actors who kind of make social media much more serious than an acting career? Where does it stand in your acting career?
In my acting career, I think social media is a great tool now to put yourself out there. And I think social media is very much like work for most of us now. So, and I really like that change happened for me in 2022. Like I really now I'm mindfully working on having this healthy boundary with my social media. And I use it as work now. Okay. And also like to connect with the people that I get so much love from, like all my followers and the people that really like my work. And I feel really grateful that I can communicate to them at any point. So that I really like that. It's a really nice tool. If you use it wisely, I think social media can be really good for your, I don't know, like professionally, it can be really good. So that is something that I'm doing very mindfully to have a really healthy boundary with it. So it's very much me. And I really like for the fact that I can like talk to people who have given me that unconditional love as an actor. There are people that I talk to on my social media with whom I've never met, but they really like me as an actor. So I feel really grateful ki aise bhi log hai duniya mein jisse main mili nahi hu, they can extend that love through, you know, social media and a screen. So that's very special. I think that boundary has gotten blurred. Jo fan aur wo wala tha, like it has become a little bit real for all of us as actors. So that is like we are more reachable now. And I somewhere like it. Also keeping in mind that you have to have a healthy boundary when it comes to that. You can't let it get you consumed. You can't be totally consumed by it all the time.
This is something I found online when I was searching for you. Is Sania Malhotra's curly hair real? What does she do to keep it that way?
Oh, yeah, very much real. And I absolutely love it. I have a few tips and tricks that I use every day for my curls.
Okay.
And I somehow managed to like develop this routine for myself as a curly girl, because growing up, I remember this was my major insecurity, because simply because I didn't know how to style my curls. I used to brush them out and used to look like a fizz ball all the time, and people used to bully me because of that. But then luckily I came across this amazing YouTube a video in which that YouTuber was styling her curly hair, and that's when I realized that I can too do that. So I wash my hair, I condition it, and then I put a leave-in conditioner and a gel to hold the curls in their place. And all the curly girls who are watching this interview and want to get inspired and maybe try out a few things, they can definitely like Google. There are a various amount of methods that you can use for curly hair, and I would always encourage people to embrace your natural texture, because I grew up watching a lot of like fake, straight, very sleek hair, shiny. And that's what I used to see on screen, you know, and that growing up, that really induced a lot of insecurity in me. Mujhe lagta tha, jiske seedhe baal hai and they are nice looking people who have curly hair, they really have to struggle. So I'm glad now we have so many like all these influencers and amazing people who have embraced their curls and natural texture. And I would also, as an actor, like to motivate young girls who don't know how to curl their hair. Google it. There are various methods that you can use to, you know, embrace the natural texture. I love my curls.
Nice.
Love my hair.
Absolutely. You should. I mean, they really make you stand out. So I think you had a great year, and I hope you have an absolutely fantastic 2022. Hope to see you more in all the beautiful roles. Thank you so much, Sanya. Best of luck for you.
Thank you so much, Manju, for doing this. Please take care of yourself and healthy and stay hydrated. Stay at home. If you're stepping out, wear the mask.
Of course.